Yo, 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 what's good with it? CPA Strength here. And who am I? I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. What do you do, CPA Strength? I teach the world accounting basics, fundamentals, blocks by blocks, fundamentals by fundamentals. Let's go. It's like hitting off a tee in baseball. Practice, practice, practice. Let's go. What are you going to do today, CPA Strength? I don't know. What am I going to do? What are you going to teach the world today? I'm going to do number 44 in my classic series, my Counting for Beginners classic series, 44. Hold on, if you want to see the other 43 videos, soon to be a lot of videos, it's the best playlist in the world. It's right up here. This is the best accounting playlist in the world, and you can be a CPA, you can do whatever you want. Just watch this, watch that. Now this video right here, this is Accounting for Beginners number 44. All right, inventory perpetual, weighted average. Basically, it's the weighted average. We just did first in, first out. Then the next video was last in, first out. Now is weighted average. This is the third video in a row that we have mostly all the same facts. Just how we value the inventory, how we value the cost of what we're selling here is changing on this video, on this third video of inventory valuation, how we evaluate the inventory. Let's go. How are we going to value this inventory? I did want to say, you know, like my pictures have changed in every single video because I'm trying to progress. That's what I like. Progression, I don't know, that's what's fun for me, progressing in things. So I tend to get addicted in things, and now I just kind of, I'm addicted to lifting weights, and I'm addicted to making Accounting for Beginners videos. So I don't know, it's two things I really love to do. So let's go. So we're gonna do this one. All right. I'll get my pen in hand. Enough of the funny business. Let's go. 5 minutes. Zone out. Put your phone on airplane mode. I mean, maybe if your test is coming up soon, but. All right. This is DC Adler. All right. This is my mapping system. This is very important. If you don't know it, learn it. Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. I have the asset circled because we're dealing with inventory, and inventory is an asset. Like I said before, we're dealing with inventory, the perpetual, so we're dealing with the costs and the profits and inventory, like as per sale or per day, perpetually. We're doing the weighted average this time with our inventory, which in my opinion, probably it makes the most sense to me. It's probably the easiest. I would just do this. Unless I'm dealing with like a huge, huge company, millions and millions of dollars of inventory, because then it would make, you know, a cent makes a difference. Whew, I talk so much about other stuff, but maybe that's why you like me. We're gonna simulate this business, the inventory of the building, just like we did FIFO and LIFO. Now we're doing weighted average. Let's go. Hold on a second. I need a drink of some water. I mean, by now you know the drill. If not, here's the facts. We know inventory is an asset. And here's the first thing we did. Here's the first one. January, bought one widget for $10. So here it is. Here's that January widget, $10. There it is in our building, the January $10 widget. All right, next month, February, bought one widget for $20. Here's the February widget for $20 right here. So now we've got our January and our February in our warehouse. March, next month, we bought another widget for $30. So they keep on going up like inflation. Like inflation does, keeps on going up year to year. So it's a simulation of sorts. So March, so here's our March one for $30, and it parks right here in our building. We have 60 in our beginning inventory because we have March for 30, February for 20, and January for 10. So we have $60 in our beginning inventory. That makes sense to everybody, right? I mean, I was just thinking in my head, like, what you gotta do sometimes is just slow down. And I think a lot of times, I saw a comment like this, and it happened to me as well. I tend to overcomplicate things, and you know, just slow down and try to figure it out. Like if I say, well, what's our beginning inventory? And you go, I don't know. And I'm like, yes, you do. Just, you know, you gotta slow down. You know, inventory is an asset. You know, it's something we've got for resale. You know, these widgets, that's what we're doing. You know, we've got three different widgets here. One for 30, one for 20, one for 10. You know all this, just slow down. And you know your beginning inventory is all three of these added up, so it's $60. Three of these is 60. All right. So let's see, we're gonna divide, $60 total. And then we're gonna divide by three for the weighted average. So I don't know what they weight on, I just like to call it the average. That makes sense to me, because that's what the average is. It's when you take a couple, you know, things and divide by the amount of them like this. This is how you get the average. Because, so our average is $20 a piece. $20 a piece is the average. So that's how we're gonna evaluate. Basically, that's how we're gonna evaluate this inventory with the average. See that? Or it's gonna be 20. Because one was a little more, one was a little less. One, you bought one in January, February, March, one a piece, and then you have $60. April, you went for a fiesta. Fiesta, siesta, you went down to Mexico. Vamos a la playa. See? Then you came back, now you're ready to grind. You're ready to hit it hard, you're ready to hit it running. May, you sold a widget for $50. So look, you had all this that we've talked about. We figured out that whatever widget comes out doesn't matter, because we're just doing the weighted average, the average of these. Doesn't matter when it came in, it's just everything in the inventory is $60 divided by three, so that's 20. So any of these three widgets that we sell is $20. And the ones we leave in here is going to be $20 each. They're valued all at $20 for our inventory. That's how we're valuing them. So look, we sell a widget for $50. Look, there I am. Or that's me probably, or it could be somebody else. That's in DC Adler Inc. running the world, taking over the world one accounting video at a time. Anywho. Let's figure out what happened here. Sales, $50. That makes sense to everybody. I just sold one for $50. Or we did, so there's $50. Cost of goods sold. COGS, cost of goods sold. Well, think about it. How much did the good that we just sold cost? See how I like you to write it out? How much did the goods that we just sold cost? $20. We just talked about that a whole bunch. So I found it. I'm getting this. This is cool. Right? So $20. So I say, how much profit did we make on that sale? Come on, you know that's... Calm down. How much profit? Think about it. Profit. What did we do? Well, what's profit? Like we sold something and then hopefully we sold it for more than we bought it for. Is that true? Yeah, because we sold it for 50, we bought it for 20, 50 minus 20, our profit's $30 on that. Sweet, this is easy peasy, Japanese-y, maybe even easy peasy lemon squeezy, I don't even know. What's our beginning inventory? Our beginning inventory was 60, because we had a widget for 30, a widget for 20, and a widget for 10. 30 plus 20 plus 10 equals 60. Cost of goods sold. Well, we already, that's the good that we sold, how much did it cost us? It cost us $20, because they're all $20. Beginning inventory was 60. We sold 20. And how much is in our inventory? That's what we're trying to figure out now. How much is our inventory? I don't know. Yes, you do. Look, you had three. we sold, doesn't matter which one, of, we're just gonna say we sold the $20 one, right? So we still have two in our inventory. All right, inventory. So we still have, and they're all, and they're everything's valued at 20. This one's sold, so this one's a cost of goods sold. Everything's 20. So ending inventory. Well, you would know it's 60 minus 20, but here's it illustrated. There was 60, this one's sold, so there's 40 left. Anyways, I hope you really liked that. I am loving making these. It's a blessing that I can do these. And now I have people worried that I'm gonna burn out on doing this, but I mean, the most fun I have is making a video. So anyways, till the next one, deuces.